of a 31-year-old woman whose body was found stuffed inside a sleeping bag, faced a judge today.
And during the court hearing, we learned more about the timeline leading up to the victim's death. Fox 8's Linda Schmidt joins us live from Lower Manhattan with the details. Linda?
Yeah, and this is one of those disturbing stories that really just boggles the mind. How could one human being do something so gruesome? Well, now this man has been charged, the suspect, and he has a lengthy criminal history. 55-year-old Chad Irish has been charged with shooting 31-year-old Yazmeen Williams in the head and then stuffing her body in a sleeping bag. Prosecutors say he used his motorized wheelchair and a dolly to drag her body outside, dumping it next to garbage bags at a NYCHA complex at East 27th Street and 2nd Avenue in Kips Bay. Irish says he did not kill Williams. When he was taken into custody, angry neighbors and some of the victim's family surrounded him, throwing punches and screaming. In court today, prosecutors laid out a timeline. On June 26th, they say surveillance video shows Irish and Williams arguing in the apartment building hallway, and Irish is heard saying, "I'll shoot you." 4 days later, on June 30th, surveillance video in the same hallway shows Williams carrying a garbage bag to the garbage chute. That is the last time she is seen on video. About 1:30 in the morning on July 1st, a different woman is seen arriving at the apartment with a large plastic bag and cleaning supplies. She hands Irish the supplies at the door, but does not go into the apartment. 4 days later, on July 5th, surveillance video allegedly shows Irish in a wheelchair, pulling a sleeping bag on a dolly. When investigators searched his apartment, they say they found three different caliber bullets. And prosecutors also say there is another case involving Irish using a gun to menace a man just a few days after Williams' murder. And also today, prosecutors revealing his lengthy rap sheet. First of all, he's got six prior felony convictions. Five of those are violent felonies. He also has 11 misdemeanor convictions. He remains in custody. Back inside to you.
All right. So I sat on this one for about a week. And just to kind of see what, you know, what would unfold. But this guy right here, Chad Irish, he has a lot of questions that he needs to answer, but somehow I believe those questions will never be answered. I think this guy knows how to play the game. You know, his rap sheet goes back to the 80s. In 1994, he tried to blow up his own uncle, and just recently he was paroled in 2022 after a conviction on robbery charges. So to me, it would seem like this guy has been a menace for a long time up there in New York. And I'm all for second chances, but my thing is, at what point do those involved in the criminal justice system say, this guy's had multiple opportunities to get himself together, to get his life together and turn things around? I mean, we're talking about three decades where this guy's had a chance to turn things around, and so far he hasn't. And I think it was only a matter of time before he eventually would graduate, you know, to that next level. And unfortunately, Yazmeen Williams got caught up in that and lost her life in the process. But when you see stuff like this go down, it just makes you ask, does prison reform work? Because it would seem that people are coming out worse than, every time that they go in and they come out, you know. And I know it's up to the individual to decide how they will move forward and better their lives, because it works for some, but for the others who have established a pattern, a consistent pattern of behavior that, you know, shows their inability to function in society, what is to be done with them? Because you can't have people out here running around terrorizing an entire neighborhood. Because, I mean, we see it all the time where people, they go to prison, they come out, they do the same things, and then eventually they end up taking somebody's life. And, I know he'll have his day in court because you're innocent until proven guilty. But now that there's a timeline of events showing where Yazmeen Williams never left his apartment because, I mean, it's on camera in the apartment building, and along with another video of him dragging the sleeping bag down the street that her body was found in. I mean, to me, I mean, that's some, you know, some incriminating stuff right there, you know, for a person who said they didn't do anything. But I think with something like this, man, it just exposes the flaws and failures around the broken system. And I think people are pissed off and fed up that nothing seems to be done about it until somebody loses their life. And then only then is something done about it. So I think he's done. And given his track record, if he is convicted, hopefully he won't be able to get out anytime soon. And hopefully the family of Yazmeen Williams can at least, you know, find some kind of closure and get some kind of justice. Because, I mean, it's that whole situation, man, I mean, it's sick. It's disturbing, and it's horrific. So y'all take care. Stay safe. Peace.